So J.Schreck, and I'm with James. Myths, legends, and lies, and let the adventure begin. So what are we going to do today? We're going to go to, I guess I answered my own question, so I guess.
Yeah. You got this. Take it away.
So we're taking off. It's now 6 o'clock exactly. We're about a quarter of the way through Phoenix. We're going to go up 17. We're on the 10. We're going to hit the 17. We're going to go to Flag. We're going to jump on 40. Head east towards Albuquerque, and Two Guns, I believe it's about 35 miles. I think it's about 35. I've been there a couple times. Now, what I'm trying to do today, James, is this. You know, we probably should have got our asses out of bed a little earlier, but that didn't happen. So now we'll fast forward to 6 o'clock. And that might seem early, but man, I want a drone shot. The whole deal is, I haven't been able to get drone shots at Two Guns.
Because the wind?
The wind is absolutely, even when we went to Canyon Diablo, which is across, mm-hmm. which is north of there, I couldn't even do audio, it was so bad. And I want to take you up there, even though I've been up there. Also, I had one of our subscribers talk about, because we've got two videos out on the Apache Death Cave right now, was like, well, you wouldn't get a horse down that ramp that when we go in. So what I want to do today, a little bit on the Myths, Legends, and Lies, is could they have put 40 horses in that cave? So there's two things I want to do that I really want a drone shot. So I'm going to try to haul ass up there, because usually the wind's a little calmer in the morning, right? Mm-hmm. And then what I want to do is I really want to look at that.
Is that the story? The horses went in there?
Yeah, because they had to hide the horses too.
Okay.
Because, you know, there's 40 plus Apache, right? That's the story.
That's the story, yeah.
And they're hiding out in the cave. But I never looked at it till she said that. Because the reality of it is that the cave could have a different entrance from, you know, 100 something years ago. That'd be, like 140 years ago. But the cave didn't get bigger. So did the cave have enough room to put 40 horses? That's a lot of horses, right?
Yeah.
So could you have fit 40 horses in there and see if the legend's true, or is it a myth? I mean, you know, supposedly there is actual footage of and pictures of the guy that built Two Gun, which is the second generation of that area,
mm-hmm.
actually selling the skulls that were found in the cave.
Okay.
Which is kind of weird, but it's true.
You know.
Okay. And then there was another murder that happened in that location, too. So there's not just one murder, which is a whole bizarre, but that's another. Well, it's not another. We'll do that, too, when we get there. We'll go through that house also.
Okay.
Because the remnants of that house is still there also.
All right.
So that's where somebody was murdered on location by the partner, basically the guy that actually ran it with another guy, right? The partners killed each other. And then he ended up getting acquitted and coming back and living there, and the widow lived there. So there's a lot of weird shit going on up this place. So
all right.
So I'd like to get a drone shot. I'd like to look and see if could you really get 40 horses in that cave. And then there's a place that where all the demons are at. I want you to go by yourself.
Well, of course. Why wouldn't you want me to go? Hang out with demons.
Are you claustrophobic?
No, I'm
that don't bother you?
Good. That doesn't bother me at all.
Good, because there is a place that gets pretty tight, and there's a back room, and so I'm going to send you in the back room. It's pretty tight, but it's not like crazy tight. It's not like getting on your belly and nothing like that. It's squeezing through, but
I got that. I got that going for me with the
So I need to pull out Skinny Scorpion today.
Skinny Scorpion.
Can you pull out your superhuman power, Skinny Scorpion?
I think I can do that. I think I can do that. We'll see.
So, and today too, we're trying to make what we call the Holbrook Loop, which would be to 17 to 40, and then down through Holbrook, and then back towards Phoenix to make a big U. J.Schreck, Myths, Legends, and Lies. And guess where we're at? We're back at the Apache Death Cave with James. Everybody ready to go for an adventure? You know, we're going to do two things today. Man, I was stressing to try to get some drone footage, and we got some drone footage. I don't know how good it is, but we at least got it. The wind never stops up here, and that's one of the hardest things about the Apache Death Cave. I had one of my subscribers say, you know, you couldn't get a horse down in that hole. So me and James decided what we're going to do today is we're going to go down. We're going to really explore it. He loves to go in the tight places. We're going to go way back in the back room. We're also going to go down where could they put 40 horses down here? Now, I don't think this was the original entry we're going to go into, but could they have put 40 horses down here? You know, that's what we're going to kind of look at today. And then we're going to see what kind of ghosts are down there, because James loves ghosts. And by God, if there was no reason that there should be a ghost after 43 people died in this one hole, sure in hell should be a ghost, right? So come along. Let's go down in the Apache Death Cave. You going, James?
I'm in.
Hell yes. Let's do this. Might need a light. J.Schreck, Myths, Legends, and Lies. And guess where we're at? We're back at the Apache Death Cave with James. Everybody ready to go for an adventure? You know, we're going to do two things today. Man, I was stressing to try to get some drone footage, and we got some drone footage. I don't know how good it is, but we at least got it. The wind never stops up here, and that's one of the hardest things about the Apache Death Cave. I had one of my subscribers say, you know, you couldn't get a horse down in that hole. So me and James decided what we're going to do today is we're going to go down. We're going to really explore it. He loves to go in the tight places. We're going to go way back in the back room. We're also going to go down where could they put 40 horses down here? Now, I don't think this was the original entry we're going to go into, but could they have put 40 horses down here? You know, that's what we're going to kind of look at today. And then we're going to see what kind of ghosts are down there, because James loves ghosts. And by God, if there was no reason that there should be a ghost after 43 people died in this one hole, sure in hell should be a ghost, right? So come along. Let's go down in the Apache Death Cave. You going, James?
I'm in.
Hell yes. Let's do this. Might need a light.
I'm in.
Hell yes. Let's do this. Might need a light. I got enough batteries to kill us. Be careful. Real deal, isn't it?
Oh, that's cool, man.
Be careful on the way down here. I got lights and batteries. Okay, one of the places that we want to look at is on the right hand side when you go in,
right here. It goes back down in there.
Now that I got James,
we're gonna run that down once we come back
and see what we got down there.
Seek!
Seek!
I didn't do that because we might sink these two together. Sorry. And then these are the little things that they made, you know, for the
tour.
Yeah. Okay, the first thing when you come in here, you notice this piece right here. Holy shit. And you know you're in a cave right now, because all of a sudden this gang, it's lowered itself about 20, 25 degrees. Yeah, probably 20. And then you look up in here. I don't know. So, you know, could they put, say, 10 horses if they had them lined back up? James, what do you think?
I feel like you could, because it's obviously you're not looking for anyone's comfort when you're in that circumstance. You know what I mean? Like, if you're cramming something in here, you could have done it. I don't think they would have been happy about it.
This piece of steel right up here. Old style rebar. You start getting a different vibe. It also has moist up through here. There's the last time that I was in here. I did my little thing right in this area right here. But turn the lights off just real quick, James. Just to show people that I was telling you, even right here, could we stumble out of here? Yeah, but man, it's pitch black. Just because I know where it's going, you know, I know that I'd be going that way, right? But and I'd have to hand it, you know, hand feel it through. I sure in the hell wouldn't want to, though. And see, this goes way up there to the top, and it goes way up there, almost to the. And then here is the back. That'd be a nice rock to hit you on the head. So could you get these horses back here? Yeah, you know, I mean,
if there's enough clearance.
You know, and I don't know what this floor looked like right here. That's the thing. You know, I don't know what it looked like at that time, back in the day. James?
Yeah.
There you are.
This is my little.
Yes. You want to take that light with you?
I'll get this guy. I'm fine.
Well, you don't have to worry about. Now, I went about three quarters of the way.
Okay.
You have to be a skinny scorpion to get in that shit there, James. Yeah, you might want to take your bag. You might want to leave your bag.
I'm going to leave my pack here.
You didn't eat a big dinner, did you?
No. Look at this. So there's benefits of being real tiny.
Nooks
and crannies
all over this place. Yeah, I wouldn't want to have to do
this by myself.
Yeah, it'd be kind of weird. As James goes into the abyss. I can still hear him crawling around. How wide is it there, James?
What's that?
How wide is it?
My shoulders. So, you know, the shoulders of a 12-year-old girl.
Oh, man. You know, this is a creepy-ass place, though. I tell you what.
Okay, I've almost hit my limit. I'm at the little, it says go no further. Ominous.
It says go no further?
It literally has a little writing that says go no further on it. That's funny. Well, you know what that means.
You know when you're in here and he's back there, but you're back here by yourself, you always think something's coming up behind you. You know, I don't know what these floors look like at the time that, you know, they had this. And, you know, who knows how far. I mean, you got to think about this. This is 130 years, you know. There's 130 years.
Before I can no longer go anywhere.
So, you know. I don't know, that's kind of a weird thing hanging off the wall right there. But, I mean, you look up in here. Pretty creepy.
With going just past no further. Watch your head there. There's a boulder you can smack yourself on if you're taller than me. I'm going to scoop my way on back to Jeff. But to give you an idea, it just keeps going. We'll work our way back.
Did it dead end?
Yeah, it gets to a point where I can't see sideways.
Does it look like people have gone forward?
No, it does not. I think you'd have to be a child to get any further than I just went. I actually struck my rib cage through it, but I couldn't shimmy any further.
You know, I see light up there at this very top.
Yeah, there's a little spot that pokes through. I saw.
There you have it.
There's the point of no return.
Marked in Sharpie.
Of course.
Very official.
Okay, so let's kind of get a little quiet and let's kind of look around. Tell you what. Let's go dark, James. Let's just see if we got any. You know, last time I was in here, and I'm not shitting you, man, a cool breeze, whether it's a breeze that came from another part of the cave or whatever, came through this son of a bitch, and I'm telling you what, made the hair on my legs, my arms, I should say. Does anybody in here want to talk to us? Walking back there.
That was me. That's my name.
Good. You know, so